on, everybody. Brandon Hayes with the Next Up Show. And this is the cream. The camaraderie, the bullshit, all that kind of stuff. And it's kind of funny that we're starting off the podcast with the jiu-jitsu side of things. And the reason why I'm doing that is me and AJ did some interviews with, my wife Erica, Mary Ortega Ripley, and Marissa Barnes. And as soon as we got done, I get a phone call from you. And you're like, dude, I've got a perfect idea for a podcast, a subject on the podcast, all that kind of stuff. Dude, I'm going to kind of let you go into that because I think it's highly entertaining. And I can go in depth on some instances on the high-end gi game. Let's just call it that.
Well, I think with every jiu-jitsu practitioner comes the fashion side, right? You got to look good on the mats. So
some would probably argue with you on that, but yeah, let's go down that rabbit hole.
You dress like $1 million, you make $1 million. Well, what I've always been told.
Look at you. You're looking good right now. So
I made about 20.
So go ahead, man. Let's hear about it.
Well, recently got into looking into some Shoya rolls.
Okay. Okay. You
know, it's top of the line gi, it's what we're all, when you get into jiu-jitsu, it's the main name you hear for you're looking for a gi,
It's kind of like a Jordan.
So, yeah.
Like a Jordan shoe.
Probably argue if it's the best or not, but.
Well,
it's the one everybody's drawn to. So started looking into some myself and kind of trying to get into maybe doing a little bit of reselling on some geese too.
Okay. A little bit of a hustle then. A
little bit.
Okay. All right. So, go ahead, man.
Found a pretty good deal on eBay for one. I started off by buying one. I was just going to buy it. It's the dove gray. Sky blue patches on it, but...
The shirt little thing, I kind of got out of that. One person need picked me up as an athlete, so,
Well, we went ahead and decided to pick up our first Shoya roll. I got it in the mail. It looked pretty good. Felt pretty good, I never had one, so I didn't really know for sure.
Did you roll better?
I hadn't worn it yet.
Okay, all right.
When I had decided to purchase a few more. I was thinking about reselling that one.
Okay.
So we found a guy that had a good deal on a few of them. I think we ended up buying 10 of them total.
When you say good deal, what's a good deal? Hey, let's get to the audience. And, some of these people that probably are not in the jiu-jitsu community, or they might just say, screw you, I don't care what I look like on the mat. I'm there to murder. I'm there to... Go that route. I'm not trying to look good, so go ahead.
Well, we can just cut all the bullshit.
Yeah, go ahead, man.
We bought some bullshit ass geese. We bought some bullshit ass geese.
When you say bullshit, are you talking they were used, worn out, or were they a fugazi?
They're fugazis.
Oh shit!
That's what we're talking about. We're talking about fugazis.
Okay, all right. Go ahead and go down that right there.
So. Really, the long and the short, we wanted to maybe see if we could get some geese for a good price and then maybe resell them to some of the people in the gym. I'm good at hustling. Thought maybe I could hook a few people up. People don't want to spend the $300-$400 on the Shoya rolls. And so we found some Ruka Batch 60s, some white and some black ones,
okay.
A1s and A2s. Yeah, it was the same guy I had bought the gray one from, which that one I think we ended up paying $120 for that one.
Okay.
He was asking $180, and we, bid on it back and forth a couple times, and ended up getting it for.
What, before you keep going on, what platform were you? You were
saying on eBay.
Okay, so yeah, eBay. Then. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. And at the time, obviously, I had not owned one, so I don't know that much about them. Okay. Still, really don't, honestly.
Okay. I got you on that.
Since I haven't had a real one. So yeah, so we bought 10 more, and we got them for, I think they were $120 a piece for those two. Maybe not 100 a piece.
100 a piece.
Yeah.
So eight to ten geese.
Yeah, I ended up spending about $1,000 in geese. Started researching after that. Upon my research and investigation, start to question if this is really a good deal or not.
Okay.
So
I'm going to take it. It was not a good deal.
It wasn't a good deal.
Okay. So when that happens, and I can go back on the headaches of the second and third market of specialized items, and Jordan shoes are a major part, Boost, Yeezys or whatever, there's that major second market, and it's like that first market are the people that are lucky that have a hookup, or they're in that. I know, Jordan, that you can become part of something, and you're the first people that get to buy a shoe or something. All right, guys, we got to take another break. I need you guys to check out this video. Craig G.
Originality.
At the party, they swelling the guest list. Bust your melon in seconds. What this felon perfected is an arsenal of lyrics. Your dwellings defenseless. Yeah, you know me, raise the bullhorn to send in contestants. So if it's beef, then it's beef. We ain't mending the fences. Chiropractic for your brain, see I'm bending your senses. Got enough ammo for you and your men in the trenches. One intelligent sentence answers relevance questions. You clowns are coming off, it's like you have celibate sessions. My skills are from another world, it's angelic in presence. And still I go for what I know in the relic confession.
All right, everybody, we're coming back from that video. Craig G.
That was originality.
All right.
I dig it.
There we go. So, but when you look at it that way and you're trying to make the money off of it and you're, you know, the conversation that we had that day where you sat there and you're like, there's got to be a platform to where the, a white or a blue belt can, They people get educate them on it, I'm sitting there kind of laughing, and I was laughing with you and at you a little bit because of the whole situation, because it was like, dude, you should have just asked, because there's a couple people in the gym that know a little bit about it, and all that kind of aspects, and brand new batch 60 Rukas and all that, show you were only going to sell their shit for fucking $120, and you're not going to be able to go buy them in bulk and everything. But you're talking about the second market and dealing with people. Well, eBay is a sketchy thing to do. Craigslist is a sketchy thing to do. And then you got the Facebook market also. And, my big thing was when I was looking at, when I was doing the Show Your Roll and all that, and as soon as, to everybody out there, the Show Your Roll, it used to be if you owned one of those, your jiu-jitsu went up by 15 to 20% automatically. I mean, if you didn't know how to do Barambola, you automatically knew how to do it. So, and I'm bullshitting on that. But, I had some headaches with a guy that was trying to scam me out of a gi, like money and all that. And it came out that he ended up scamming a bunch of people. I got my gis back and all that kind of stuff and threatening messages and all that kind of shit. Hey, you guys are going to have to let us take this break here right now. I need you guys to take a peek at this video. Prozac.
Until then.
Slowly fade away into the lyrics of the song. Searching for sanctuary, peace of mind, but something's wrong. I lost myself along the way and it's been far too long. Somebody tell me where's my kindred spirit. I try to transcend, and all I catch is interference. How will this all end? Hoping that someone can hear this. Let pills dissolve in. I think I'm finally thinking clearest. Just hope you feel this. Things will never ever be the same again. I hope that you will understand the pain I was in. I wanna thank you for the times of being a friend. Sorry I've reached the end. Maybe I'll see you again.
All right, we're back from that break. I dug that. Prozac.
Yeah, until then. Good.
All right. Go a little bit more into how you dealt with it and,
Well, the only reason
I think you came out on top, really.
The only reason I did it off the get-go is because eBay has a good protection plan for situations like this. So I did contact eBay because I knew deep down that I was a little uncertain about the whole situation. I knew my level of intelligence in dealing with shorter rolls and what I actually knew to be able to spot one and all that. I knew I didn't know that much. So the only reason I even followed through is because they had my back at the end of the day. And so it just didn't sit right after I bought them. I bought them and they were in the mail, $1,000 out of the account. And then just wasn't sitting right. I'm like, man, I got to keep investigating this. So I ended up digging. I found a number for a guy at Show Your Roll.
Who'd you talk to?
I don't remember his name. I got it in my phone if I had to pull it up. But it's just a guy at one of the Show Your Roll offices. I found it through just Google searching, and I ended up coming across the blog where somebody had posted it. It was like, It wasn't publicly posted or nothing like that. It was just something I randomly came across. And I called, dude answered, and we chatted for a minute. And I was just kind of asking him, hey, how can you tell, especially if you're buying these online? And once we got to what kind it was the batch 60 Ruka, he's like, hey, we weren't selling me. We didn't sell very many of these. If this dude's got, you know, 8 of them or 10 of them, and he's got them sitting in the closet and multiple kinds. So
Andy's selling them under market price.
Right.
Market price.
Sure.
That's for first market too. So.
Right.
Okay.
Which, I mean, you know, it was a little lower than a fair price, but at the same time, I mean, you could see a situation maybe where somebody would sell in bulk like that, you know, if they just really had a bunch of geese sitting around. But Shoyer only sold 2 per person of those, and dude had a whole 2 boxes of them, you know. So I sent a couple messages to him, and I just kind of let them know, hey, I already know what this is before they even get to my house, you know. And he was acting kind of sketch off the giggle. Once you go back and read the messages, you can kind of be like, all right, I can see where this guy was sort of, he was being a little sketchy himself, you know, make it. Just keywords he was putting in his messages back and forth to me to make sure, like, I was happy with the first one before I bought the other ones, you know. Little comments like
gotcha.
That.
Gotcha.
And so, really, we ended up getting my money back. I made him refund all my money, and he did, because I told him, you know, if he wasn't going to refund the money, then we were going to have to follow through whatever I need to follow through to get my money back, you know, which...
Brings a lot of heat to him and... account being blocked and
yeah exactly putting him out of business on eBay, which is really the only way you're gonna be able to sell multiple geese. You know, you can't really just sell 10 20 30 geese local that fast, you know what I mean? Like, you can on eBay. So yeah, so he ended up refunding my money. However, he refunded before I actually received the packages.
Okay,
so he refunded it that day, so I got him to refund my money like instantly to avoid me taking these geese when I get them and sending them to Shoyer Roll with his information and whoever else I could give them to, you know what I mean?
That'd be some shit right there. That's.
I mean, I wanted to see if they're authentic, so whether I had to send them to Shoyer Roll or whoever deals with that, with the fraudulent crap, if you're going to try to take my money.
Well, nah, dude, that's 100%.
But yeah, so eBay had no problem refunding the money. They gave it back. Well, he wanted me to return the packages, and they ended up showing up.
Okay,
all right. And so... here we are. I actually still have them. Deciding what to do. We're trying. We've had some conversations about this, trying to decide what the best route to do with these are.
We got a nice fire pit outside, man.
We could burn
right out of the market.
We could burn a couple, see how they burn.
There we go.
We could. We talked about sending a box full of stinky geese back to them.
Instead. I remember you bringing that up. So I mean, I still think we need to do that.
And
like a disposable camera that like we Wi-Fi and all that when he opens it up, and then we'll come back.
Do you have like a mailing address for the viewers where they can like send their stinkiest gear to and put it in a box?
We're gonna write that one down, AJ. We're writing that down definitely.
Hey, if you got stinky boxes out there, send them in.
I don't know, man.
Hey, we'll just put a homeboy's address up on there.
Oh no, dude.
Just send them right to the source.
You don't know something? We'll talk about that. That we're gonna shelf that right there for right now.
I promised to spare him for refunding me the money. I did tell him I didn't feel comfortable sending him back a bunch of geese to put back in the market. So I did want to take them off the market. I have no intention of reselling them. You know, if I do, I'm gonna put a big old red X through them or something. Let them know that they're fake, or you know, at least make sure whoever. I mean, a geese. At the end of the day, a geese still a geese without the patches. So you know,
100%, man.
If we make good training geese, we got to rip the patches off or whatever. I want to make sure we get good use out of them.
I mean, I look at it this way. I don't think anybody would really care. I mean, if they're getting a fair price for a geese, I mean, if you look at the low end geese, I mean, shit, you're seeing some of them going for $40, $50 nowadays, and you're like, man, there's no reason why anybody should not be able to say, anybody that says, no, I can't do jiu-jitsu, one, I'm out of shape, or two, it's just too expensive to start, I gotta buy a gi or anything. It's like, dude, no. Somebody in the gym will throw you a gi. If you show up for the first month or two of you coming and you're there regular, dude, I'm one of the first people to be like, man, I got a gi that'll fit you and everything, and if you stay with it, you know, you can just have it and stuff.
Well, I'm not gonna be messing with any Shoyer Rolls, that's for sure. Oh, so that's put a bad taste in my mouth for sure. That's already too much of a pain.
But
in the butt.
It's not Shoyer Rolls' fault.
No, it's not Shoyer Rolls' fault at all. But it's just this from the aspect of reselling, it's just not worth the time. I'd rather buy cheap geese, or you know, I just bought a brand new tatami off somebody at the gym for $40 that just didn't fit right. So. If I was hard, shouldn't I be taking care?